Hello everyone, hope you guys are doing great. So I had actually planned a different video this weekend, but some of you had commented about trying EvolutionX in a Redmi Note 10 Pro. So I flashed the ROM and I have been using this ROM for almost a week now. And in today's video, I'll give you a brief overview about the performance of this ROM. And at the end of this video, I'll also show you how you can flash this ROM in your Redmi Note 10 Pro. And I'm using the latest build of this ROM, which is version 6.3.1, and the security patch is May 5th, 2022. So let's get the video started and see how EvolutionX based on Android 12 performs with Redmi Note 10 Pro. First of all, let's start with the basic Android 12 features, which are similar to other Android 12 custom ROMs. So you get the privacy dashboard, notification indicators, and material view theming, and they are working absolutely fine. But there are some features which make EvolutionX different from other custom ROMs, and we'll take a look at all those features in the later part of this video. But I actually wanted to start this video with benchmark scores. So if you take a look at this AnTuTu score, it is 347,471, and the Geekbench scores are 513 for single core and 1487 for multi-core, and they're pretty decent. Now, talking about the Google applications that you get with EvolutionX, you only get a few of them like Google Calendar, Google Files, Google Alert, and Google Messaging. But you won't get YouTube or Google Photos. Well, you can download other Google applications from Google Play Store if you need them. And if you talk about Android 12 theming options, well, you get all those options like themed icons or stock wallpapers. Then there is this separate wallpaper application which is my favorite from EvolutionX, where you get some really cool EvolutionX wallpapers along with some other wallpapers as well, which is definitely a good feature here. And talking about Wideband L1 and the safety net, this ROM supports Wideband L1 and passes the safety net test, so you'll be able to stream HD content and use the banking applications without any issues. And if you talk about the battery backup, it is really excellent with this ROM. And if you are a casual user, the battery will easily last for more than 1.5 days or 2 days. And you will get a screen on time of 7 to 8 hours easily. So this looks pretty decent here. And this ROM also supports fast charging, and it takes around 1 hour and 30 minutes to completely charge the battery from 0 to 100% using the original charger, which is a little faster when compared to Dofest OS or Arrow OS. And you also get this game space where the options are more or less similar to Dofest OS. And I played one or two games like Racing Limits, BMX Racing and Apex Racing, and the performance are similar to Dofest OS. No complaints about the performance here. It is decent, but do not expect any major boost in the gaming performance here. And if you take a look at other features like refresh rate and always on display, they are working absolutely fine. And the fingerprint as well as the face unlock are pretty fast as well. And there is no issue with all that. Now, looking at the features that make EvolutionX different from other custom ROMs, Android 12 custom ROMs to be more specific, the first one is this Evolver, where you get some really cool customization options, like changing theme to complete black or changing the icon style or shape, or even changing the fonts. And you also have options to change the notification style or even customize the power button. And if you take a look at these miscellaneous features, you get options like unlimited Google Photo storage, which is great, or you can hide applications from the launcher, or you can also unlock this higher FPS feature or higher quality streams, and these are some really good features. So this was all about this Evolver, and the second feature that makes this ROM different is the Dolby Atmos. Yes, you get that feature here and it's really cool. And you get different modes like smart audio, music, movie or game. And you also have options to customize each mode separately, like changing treble, bass or even the vocal boost, and this is an amazing feature here. And since we are talking about this sound here, under sound and vibration you also get these awesome features like setting up different volume for each application, clearing speakers with a 30 second audio clip, or MI sound enhancer, which are some really good features and they are working absolutely fine. So this was all about the good things that are present in EvolutionX. Now let's take a look at some cons, and let's start with theming. So I usually use dark theme in my device, but if you try to change the theme to light, everything else will change apart from this notification bar, which is really weird and it does not look good at all. And the second issue I observed is again with these theming options. So if you enable black theme in this Evolver and then change the theme to light, then try to disable this black theme in this Evolver again, Pixel Launcher will keep stopping, which again is very weird. So if you frequently switch between light and dark themes in your device, this is going to be an issue for sure. Otherwise, if you continuously use dark theme in your device, it should work fine. And the next thing I observed was with this WhatsApp application. This was actually the first time I received a notification like this while using any Android 12 custom ROM. And the notification was about using a custom ROM, which might cause an issue with the customer services team. I actually took a screenshot here, and let me show you that screenshot here. Yeah, here you go. This is the notification I got. And one more issue was again with this WhatsApp application. So while receiving a video call, I was getting this notification on lock screen about WhatsApp not being able to start the camera, which was very weird actually. And this was the first time I was observing all this. And I am using Arrow OS as a reference here, and there was no such issue with WhatsApp application. And one more thing about EvolutionX is that it does not come with any camera application, nothing at all. And they should have at least provided Google Camera Go like DoFest OS, but I don't think we can do anything about it. So that's pretty much about EvolutionX in Redmi Note 10 Pro. And if you are okay with these small but annoying issues, this is a pretty good ROM for Redmi Note 10 Pro. And if you have flashed this ROM in your device, please let me know in the comment section, because I don't know if these issues are like with my device only or if you are facing these issues as well. So this was all about the pros and cons of EvolutionX in Redmi Note 10 Pro. Now let's move to the installation part. So after you have unlocked your device bootloader and flashed a custom recovery like TWRP, you can go to Wipe, Advanced Wipe, and clear Data, Cache, and the Dalvik. Then you can go to Format Data, type Yes and press OK, and then you can simply flash the ROM from your external storage and reboot to system. And if you want to know the step-by-step guide on how to flash TWRP, please check the video from the card above, and I will also leave a link in the video description. And I also wanted to let you guys know that I have got my hands on this Redmi Note 9 Pro, and I will try to make some videos about this device as well. So stay tuned for upcoming videos. So that's all for today's video, and I hope this video was helpful for you. And if you are new to my channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and turn on channel notifications so that you get notified whenever I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you soon in my next video.